Good day guys and welcome back to my channel. Today we'll be painting an elephant. And to be honest, this is my very first elephant and I really don't know how it's gonna come out. But the reference photo is from, of course, Pixabay. And it will be linked in the description box below. So I actually sketch it already and prepare the colors that we'll be using today. We have Venetian red. Okay, you may confuse this as burnt sienna, but in all honesty, I ran out of my burnt sienna, so I only have Venetian red with me. It's similar to burnt sienna, but I'm just gonna make adjustments later. If you have burnt sienna, that's well and good. I have black, titanium white, permanent orange, and yellow. Okay, let's begin now. I'm gonna make burnt umber kind of color by mixing the burnt sienna, Venetian red, white, and yellow. So this is like burnt umber. Nice. Okay, we can add more black. Okay. Yep, that's it. So this will be the underpainting of our elephant. Actually, I'm so excited to finish this one because it's my first elephant. Okay, add more black. There. A lot. Okay. Add black. Add brown. Yellow. Black. Black. Okay, now don't wash it, but we're going to change our brush, a little pointy. Get black, or just darken the mixture by adding black, and make some shading. As well. To those who would like to see the reference photo while painting, or to look at the reference photo while painting, you can download first the link. You can download first the image, which is linked in the description box below, and then save it on another device, and you know, look at it side by side, the painting and the reference. In the future, I'll find a way to insert the reference image while I'm painting, so that it would also be easier for you to see what I'm doing. Although I don't see any difficulty in downloading the image. It's pretty easy. You can use your laptop and use your phone all at the same time. I'm actually just using my phone to see the image. use black. Okay, we're gonna mix black and yellow and probably orange. Okay, like that. Okay, more orange. Yellow. Okay, water it down. Here, add more yellow. Then mix it with black here. Black. Yeah, same mixture. Black. Okay. Black, white, orange mixture here. For the trunk, it has to be, again, my favorite word, random, because it has a lot of wrinkles. Okay, orange and brownie orange here, this side, and then go black again. Oops, got it. Add yellow, orange, white, orange, yellow. Okay, yellow, orange, sorry. Okay, here, add yellow. Okay, more down. Black. Black. Okay. Get some black. Okay. Just create the brownie orangey mixture. So just combine black, orange, orange, and then yellow. Okay, water down. Okay, yellow. I think I need more yellow, or we're gonna use the permanent yellow D. Okay, yeah, I think that's better. Okay, permanent yellow D mix with orange and some black here. Here. Okay, white. Okay. And then just blend. Mm-hmm. Okay, wash your brush out. I think I added too much white. Okay, now we're going to get some gray mixture or burnt umber mixture. So Venetian red. If you have burnt umber, that's better. I'm just mixing my own colors. Burnt umber, I mean Venetian red, black, yellow. Okay, that's good. Here. Okay. Okay, here I'm gonna finish it with burnt umber. Get some black. Right. Okay, here. Okay, get some black, pure black, and just like define or outline the face. Okay, wash your brush out. Water. Wash your brush out. Just clean it. And then we're gonna go, what is the color of this? Okay, this is black or gray. Add white, a lot of white to the mixture. Like that. More white. Okay, like that. So it's like dirty white. Okay, and then I'm gonna do the background. Okay, more white when we go down, or as we go down. Here, up. That's too dark. Oh, white. Okay, here we're gonna go a little or lighter gray here. Actually, we'll be painting some leaves and trees at the bottom. So this will be painted over. Don't worry too much. If you don't get the gray mixture, doesn't matter. I'm just underpainting it. Okay, get your orange and then permanent yellow, white, and tiny bit of black or burnt sienna. I mean, what do you call that? Raw umber. Here, shiny more white. Oh, that's a lot. That's a lot of white. Anyway, can use it. Can use it. Do some random highlights like that. Okay, here as well. Here as well. Okay. Here. Going to, oh, it's too much. Okay, that's too white. We're going to add some yellow orange with black, like that. quickly add white. Here, and then add orange here. Okay, orange and yellow. Here. Okay. So we're going to use black. And then we're going to create now the wrinkles. You can use a smaller brush, but if you're not using a smaller brush, just use the tip of that brush. And of course, control it. Black. Okay. Have you seen an elephant, like in real life? I think most of us have seen one or two. Me, I've seen it. I mean, I've seen an elephant, but not too close. Only from afar. Speaking of elephant, I just want to share my sentiment about there was this, I think I've seen it many times, especially in art groups that I'm a member of, an elephant painting. You know, like a normal, like a person, like a human being. It was painting, and maybe for some it looks like, oh cool, that elephant belongs to the art world or something like that. But then I actually feel bad for the elephant, because we have no idea about the struggle that it experienced before it actually learned how to paint. Because elephants are not supposed to paint, right? Well, anyway, I'm just sharing my sentiments. Maybe that elephant was hit. We don't know. But most probably yes. Okay, get black. Okay, black. Okay. Okay, we're gonna darken this side. It's too light. So we're going to use orange, brown, and yellow. Okay, like that. And we're just gonna glaze. That might be the wrong color. Yeah, I think that's not the right color. Anyway. Okay, anyway. We're just gonna get some like burnt umber. Light. Quite light. And brown. Yellow. Like that. Add white here. Can get some black. Or, sorry, black plus burnt sienna, or in my case, I'm using Venetian red. Just do some lines. also do some light wrinkles so that, you know, it really looks like natural. Actually, I want to change my brush. It's the same. Okay. I'm going to try a pointy brush using black. Black and orange and yellow. Yeah, better. And I want to say thank you. Thank you so much to those who have tried my tutorials. Thank you. You know, I hope you learned something from me. Here, just outline that part where the trunk begins. Some dark shading near the eye. Okay, we're gonna go back to it later so that you don't get tired of it looking at it. We're going to get black mixed with black and Venetian red to make darker shades here. So here, okay, get some black, and let's just define the elephant. Let's outline it. as well. Alright. Also, the body. Okay. Okay, we're gonna get some, we're gonna do the trunk. We're gonna get some, the tusks. We're gonna get some white with a little bit of orange and brown. I mean, orange and yellow, like that. This is just the underpainting of the tusk. Alright, next, same. Okay, like that. Okay, we can let it dry first. And actually, we don't have to wait. We can use our orange and yellow black mixture. Just add brown. And make it natural. Oops. Anyway, we're gonna fix that. Oops. Ugh. Look at that. I'm gonna add some orange to black to create that orangey brown color. Alright. I'm gonna use black. Here, black. Okay. I'm gonna use black here. All right. Use black. Okay, I'm gonna make some brown. By mixing black and orange and yellow. And then dot. Yeah, there you go. Okay. Wash your brush out. And get some white. I think I already run out of white. Get a clean brush, white, and here. Here. All right. Okay. We're going to go back to it later. We're just gonna get some orange, yellow, and black, make a light brown mixture. Okay, more white. And do this. Okay, like that. Then I'm gonna use my fingers as usual. Here. Okay, we're gonna get some yellow, then white. To the sit, oh, okay, more white. It's kind of a lot of yellow. And just, more white. Okay, gray this out by using black. Okay, and then okay, more black. Okay, all right, we're gonna add orange a bit and yellow. We're gonna try. Here. Okay. Gonna add some yellow. Yellow and orange again. And make some random lights here. Mm-hmm. orange, orange, permanent yellow. Let's fix this. Fix this part. Okay, there you go. Okay. Here also. Get some black. Okay, orange and yellow here. Orange, yellow, black, and white. Okay, that's the mixture. Orange, yellow, black, and white. Okay, now I need to glaze. Like that. And then use some burnt umber, raw umber mixture. Okay, add black to this, like that. Black. Okay, you can use the finer brush. Always touching the paint. Looking very wrinkly. Get black. Okay, not black. Mix it with a little bit of white. Here, no, that's too gray. Add black. And just do the eyes. Going to do some light light version of the orange, yellow, black mixture and just here, apply here. Go back to the trunk. Make it a little bit orange, then white. Okay. Here as well. Yeah. Like that. Just be random. Okay. Like that. And then we're going to get some black, but watered down, like really watered down. And you know me and my glazing technique here. Here. Here as well. Again, just glazing. Do not paint over the first layer of paint or here. Okay. And here. As random as possible. Get some black. I'm gonna do it here. All right. Okay. Okay, let's go back to it later. Gonna fix this part because okay. All right, let's finish it. Let's add some yellow, brown, and white here. Also here. Okay. Right. Now we're going to get. Wait. Okay, we're going to get yellow oxide. Yellow oxide and sap green. Then lemon yellow. And of course, white. We're just gonna do the background leaves. But first, we're going to make the trunk of the tree. Mix some burnt sienna plus white and then black. Oops, there's a lot of black. Okay, try to eat more black. More black here. Like that. More black. Then just gonna create some trees in the background. It's like the elephant is coming towards us. It also tells us, the background also tells us where the elephant is. It's in the wild. Well, it's good to assume that it's in the wild. And do some dark shades. All right. Okay. Okay. And make some branches. We're gonna paint over this, but it's important that we do it now so that we're just gonna do the leaves later. Okay, here as well. Okay, we're gonna go back to it later. This is just how I do my work. You can actually do the leaves first and do the stems or the branches next. It's up to you. But to me, I want to do the branches first before I proceed to doing the leaves. Okay, we're going to get sap green, oxide green mixed together. And then burnt sienna if you have one. And then like that. Okay, oxide green. Okay, tiny bit of yellow. Oops, yellow. Okay, oxide green. sap green. Okay, green mixed with black. Okay, more black. Okay, raw umber, but watered down here. The background should suggest some leaves and branches. Sap green plus plus black here, the bottom. And some darker shades here. Okay, oxide green. Plus sap green combined again. Make some leaves here. Okay, black. Here, black. Okay. Okay, we're gonna go back to it later. Even if it's just the background, I kind of like it. Okay, again. Sap green plus black. Black. Oh, that's a lot. Sap green. And then just dab randomly. Are going to do some oxide green. Here. Oxide. Oxide green plus yellow. Okay, more yellow here. and get some brown or burnt sienna mixed with the yellow and green to suggest some branches or dried leaves. Right. And just fill in the blank spaces that you see. Okay. We're gonna get sap green plus black just to add more depth. Okay, get some yellow and white. Yellow and white with more yellow. And just do some highlights here at the left side. Here as well. Okay, here as well. Don't forget the left side. Like that. I should name my elephant. What is the... Okay, I don't know. What should I name it? Okay, I'm gonna use my finer brush or pointy brush. Get some... If you have raw umber, that's good. Just lighten it up by using or by adding white. And make some lines that suggest some branches, but very light because it's from afar. Remember that the main focus of this painting is the elephant, but it's important to suggest where the elephant is so that you get the feeling of like, I don't know, jungle. Or nature. Doesn't have to be super scary jungle. Here as well, just suggest some branches that are visible through the leaves. Okay, we're gonna use some highlights, orange, yellow, it's a lot of yellow, and then like brown and white. Mute it by using black, like that. Okay, I'm just gonna highlight the tree. Oh my god, I just like put paint on my face. Okay. Right. Okay. Okay, we can actually make some brownie hints here. Again, it doesn't have to be like an in-your-face brownie color, just hints of color. Okay, here as well. Nice. Okay, here as well. Okay, add white. Add white, water it down. Okay, I just saw something. Let's use the orange mixture plus brown and yellow here. Doesn't have to be too much. Here as well. Here, make some random dabs of paints on the trunk. Get some white and just make some highlights. Okay. Just make some highlights. here. And next, that's dried acrylic rose. Okay, going to make a same brownie color mixed with black. Just to fix this part because there are some unpainted spots. Okay, we're gonna get some black. We're gonna change our brush. Oops, it's so wet. So, black in our brownie color. And just start doing this. And then lighten it a bit by using yellow, by adding yellow. Okay, more yellow here. Looking good. Okay, we're just gonna add some of these colors, like yellow, light yellow brown, and highlight the ears or the flap. Here as well. Here. Okay, we're going to get some white, then tiny bit of orange. Water it down. actually like fun to be to do. I'm so happy about my first elephant. Okay, the name of my elephant, I've decided. Dumbo. I know, right? Really creative. So Dumbo is the name of my elephant. Easy to remember. And yeah, even if my elephant only has regular size ears, still I'm naming him Dumbo. And get some orange and permanent yellow here. Yeah, that's the color that I want. It's brighter on the left side. All right. Okay, white. Okay, so good. Here. Okay, like that. Okay. Just, yeah, like that. Make some highlights here. Nice. Here. Okay. Get some yellow mixed with orange and let's try to apply some hints of it here, not actually applying it so obviously, but just hints of it. Nice. That's a lot. I don't mind. It's okay. Okay, we're going back to the trunk, oh, to the tusks of, okay, we're just gonna use a clean brush and a pure white here. Again, pure white. Here. Here. Okay. And then we're going to get pure white and watered it down just to lighten the lower portion of, or the, what do you call this? The foreground, just to lighten it. We're not actually painting over it, just give some brightness. Like that. Again here, you can water it down so that, you know, you can easily apply it. Here as well. Okay. I like it, guys. More white. I'm using my fingers. White. Okay, white. Here. Here, white, just glaze. It's like leaves. Sorry, leaves from afar. Nice. Okay, here as well. Just brighten the side or the portion near the leaves, or just immediately under the ears or the flap, and then okay, do something like this. Kind of like it. Okay, here as well, white. Okay, like that. Okay. Nice. Okay, we're gonna get some, again, pure white. And we're going to apply it here. Okay, again, pure white. Pure white. Okay, just gonna again, pure white here. Okay. And use the remaining white to highlight the elephant. It's actually nice. Alright, so I'm gonna use my white. You may choose not to do this, but I'm gonna use my watered down white to highlight the trunk. You know, even if we're painting an elephant and the elephant should be the highlight, for me, the highlight is the trunk. I love it. This is just a watered down white. I'm not changing colors here as well. Okay. We can add slight white here. Again, not too much. Okay. Okay. I think I need to get a little like blue or something. Let me use my Phthalo blue. Oh, okay, tiny bit, just tiny for the sky. It's not really there, but I don't know why I feel like it's there here. So this is just Phthalo blue, but I'm using it to suggest some blue sky in the background. Okay, yeah, like that. Here as well. You may or may not do this, but I choose to do this. I like it way better. Nice. Here as well. Just to suggest the blue sky in the background. All right. Okay, get some pure black. Okay. All right. Okay, and we're almost done. Get some brown, and then black, and then yellow. Again, brown. Here, yeah, that's it. Not too dark. Some yellow here, or white, just to lighten up a bit. It's too dark. It really looks like an elephant. Okay, get some black. And just go back to this. All right. Okay. And then we're gonna fix the eyes. I feel like it's quite, I don't know, small. Okay. Here. Right. Oops, it's a lot. Okay. Gosh, it looks like an elephant. Okay, that's good. That's really good. Okay, I need to sign it. I need to sign it, and I'm gonna use white. I'm gonna use white maybe here. Oh no, here. Okay. And we're done. We're done. We're done, guys. Thank you. Bye. Thank you, guys.